Okay, so we are on 3.1.3 of the AQA syllabus, which is the lipids topic. So, lipids, if we look at the specification, by the end of the lesson, we need to know that triglycerides and phospholipids are two groups of lipid. Triglycerides are formed by the condensation of one molecule of glycerol and three molecules of fatty acid. A condensation reaction between glycerol and fatty acids, which is RQ, forms an ester bond. The R group of fatty acids may be saturated or unsaturated. And in phospholipids, one of the fatty acids of the triglyceride is substituted by a phosphate-containing group. The different properties of triglycerides and phospholipids related to different structures, you must know those. And you must also know the emulsion test for lipids. You should be able to recognise from diagrams saturated and unsaturated fatty acids and explain the different properties of triglycerides and phospholipids. So lipids, what are they? Well, they contain carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. They are insoluble in water, but they are soluble in alcohol. And the main groups of lipids are triglycerides, which is fats and oils, and phospholipids. So the roles of lipids. So they are a long-term energy source. They are also good for waterproofing. They are good for insulation of your vital organs, which is why sort of in winter we tend to, because we feel cold, we tend to eat more fatty foods. And also for protection of vital organs such as the heart, the lungs, small intestine, etc. So triglycerides have two components. They have the fatty acid, which is the RQ group, which is a carbon atom linked to a double bonded to an oxygen and a single bond to an OH group, and then it's got a variable group called the R group, which would be the hydrocarbon tail. And the hydrocarbon tails are hydrophobic tails. And obviously a phobia means you're very scared of something. So these tails are scared of water, because hydro means water. So they will always face away from the water. And then there's a glycerol molecule, which is CCC. There's three OH groups, and then the rest are hydrogens, which is your glycerol. So triglycerides are made of three fatty acids and one glycerol molecule. So tri means three. So three fatty acids and one glycerol. So you can see here you've got your one glycerol, your three hydrocarbon tails of your fatty acids. And here you can see it that you've got the Q groups, although the OH has been taken out with another O of the glycerol. An OH from the fatty acid and another H from the glycerol has been taken out by a condensation reaction. The water has been taken out. Therefore, you've formed an ester bond. So it's one glycerol, three fatty acids. So what I would suggest you do now is pause the video and just draw a triglyceride from memory, just so you get, you process what a triglyceride is. So, as I said briefly, the free fatty acids are joined to a glycerol molecule by a condensation reaction. And as you know, a condensation reaction is where water is removed from the molecules and released from the reaction. So H2O, you take an OH from the Q group, the carboxyl group of the fatty acid, and you take a H from the glycerol, so you remove that H2O, and then what you form is a COC, which is known as an ester bond. And this happens three times because there's three fatty acids that will join, and therefore you will get three molecules of water produced for this condensation reaction. And you get three ester bonds that have been formed. see it in a different format. You get the OH from the carboxyl group of the fatty acids, and you get the H from the glycerol, and it happens three times. You get three molecules of water produced from this condensation reaction. So what I would do now is pause the video and draw a diagram to show how a triglyceride is formed so that you get to process that information. So fatty acids can be either saturated or unsaturated. So saturated means that they have all single bonds. So they have fully attached, all the hydrogens are attached, it's fully hydrogenated and it's all got single bonds. An unsaturated hydrocarbon tail is where it has at least one double bond. So if it's mono unsaturated, that means it's got one double bond. If it's poly unsaturated, it's got more than one double bond. So saturated means it's all single bonds, there's no double bonds. Unsaturated, it has at least one double bond. So now I'd like you to pause the video and draw a saturated and an unsaturated fatty acid and explain what each of those words mean. Okay, so now looking at lipids in plasma membranes, which are mainly phospholipids. So phospholipids are very similar to triglycerides, except one of the fatty acids has been replaced by a phosphate group. So you don't have three fatty acids anymore, you've got two fatty acids, and instead you have one phosphate group. Now the phosphate group is hydrophilic, so it likes water, it is attracted towards the water, so it will always face the water. Whereas the fatty acid tails are hydrophobic, they don't like water, so they will always face away from the water. So this would what they would look like in a membrane. You'd have your hydrophilic phosphate head facing towards the water, and your hydrophobic tails facing inwards away from the water. So if you dropped some phospholipids into water, they would form a phospholipid bilayer. So your hydrophilic heads would face outwards towards the water, and your hydrophobic tails will face away from the water, inwards towards each other. So yeah, just to recap that, phospholipids have a hydrophilic water-loving head and a hydrophobic water-hating tail. Well, two of them, two fatty acids, hydrophobic tails that don't like water. And phospholipids are a polar molecule. They are charged at either end. So phosphate group has a positive charge, whereas fatty acid group has a negative charge. So I'd like you to pause the video again and draw a phospholipid, label the hydrophilic and hydrophobic components. Now the final thing you need to know about lipids is the emulsion test for lipids. So what you would do is you would shake 2 centimetres cubed of the substance with 5 centimetres cubed of ethanol for 1 minute. Then you would pour into the solution 5 centimetres cubed of water. You'd shake it well. And if there is lipid, it will show up as a milky white emulsion. And the more lipid there is, the more noticeable the milky white colour. So, you should hopefully know by now that triglycerides and phospholipids are two groups of lipid. That triglycerides are formed by the condensation of 1 glycerol and 3 fatty acids. A condensation reaction between glycerol and fatty acid, which is RQ, forms an ester bond. The R group of a fatty acid may be saturated, which means it contains no double bonds, or unsaturated, where it contains at least one double bond. In phospholipids, one fatty acid of a triglyceride is substituted by a phosphate group. You need to know the different properties of triglycerides and phospholipids related, and you need to know the emulsion test for lipids. So we're just going to do an example exam question from AQA. So some seeds contain lipids. Describe how you could use the emulsion test to show that a seed contains lipids. Well, first of all, you would crush the seed with ethanol. You would add water, and then you would shake to form a cloudy white emulsion. A triglyceride is one type of lipid. The diagram shows the structure of a triglyceride molecule. A triglyceride molecule is formed by condensation. From how many molecules is this triglyceride formed? Well, you can see that it's got three fatty acids, and that is joined to one glycerol, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4. The structure of a phospholipid molecule is different from that of a triglyceride. Describe how a phospholipid is different. So phosphate is substituted for one of the fatty acids. Use a diagram to explain what is meant by an unsaturated fatty acid. Well, an unsaturated fatty acid is one with at least one double bond, and you can see that fatty acid C has one double bond. So there are double bonds present in fatty acid C.